You're insane. You're in pain. I can tell by what you're saying, but
my bad.
I'm sorry.
I forgot you were fragile. I forgot someone who doesn't even know me told you I'm an asshole. I forgot that I'm the villain. I forgot that I've all...
The Moors went into Europe. They changed the appearance of the population. Do you see? So you have Italians, Spaniards being darker than the Scandinavians. A Scandinavian person told me that they never considered the Italians or Jewish people to be white. Do you see? Because the lighter people are further north.
You the idiot that damn near ran me over, aren't you? Wait till I find your boss. He gonna fire your metallic ass.
You would do well to mind your tongue, Moore.
Ooh, you got to have major coins behind this. Who's backing you? Puffy?
Silence, Moore. I'm interested in learning more about your culture. It is my understanding that the Normans are excellent dancers.
If you want to know more about my culture, remove the dog from the table.
I'm tripping. You know our entire history is a lie? And I mean our history as an American and European history. If you look back, you notice how every single person that made any great discovery is a white European or a white American, right? Did you know that there's these group of people that used to be called the Moors, right? And I say used to because from what I've seen so far, it seems like the Europeans have done their best to basically eradicate them from existence and history. So, right, get this. You know that black people, the Moors, were here in America before the Europeans ever came over, and that's how they even knew to come over to America in the first place? You know that everything that Europeans built in their society was basically taught and given to them by the Moorish people? They taught them astronomy, they taught them running water, they taught them how to build their buildings, sacred geometry, literally all of it. And there's this event called the Reconquista, which basically was a series of battles between the Christian states and the Moors to basically eradicate them because they had most of the power in the 8th century in the Iberian Peninsula. And speaking of the Christian states, you know how Jesus, every picture that we see of him, he's white? He wasn't even white, so like that's kind of weird. Notice how always and throughout history, whoever wins, the victors write the history and they change the history? Huh. And you notice how we have a very long history of taking people that don't look like us and making them serve us? That seems a little weird. You know, on top of that, George Washington had said, we remove their turbans, we remove their sandals, and we apply heavy death penalties to anybody that basically teaches the children of the Moors about their history. In about 200 years, they won't remember who they were, they won't remember their inheritance, they won't remember their culture. And that the chopping of the cherry tree was actually that separation of cutting them off from their history and their inheritance and their culture. Like, what?
Maleficent, they called her race of people the Moors, and the Moors and I just saw it again. I was just like, yo. If you erase our history, like most black people, we don't know where we come. We think we came from slaves. We don't know our bloodline.
The two civilizations or the two cultures that are most often obfuscated, obscured, corrupted by Western academics are Egypt and the Moors, for essentially the same reason. White, quote-unquote, supremacist views said we can't allow these people who we know are distinctly African, that we would misname black or Negro. We can't recognize that these are the people that were our tutors.
This is what Revelation 13 and 7, it said they made war with us because we were the ones living throughout Europe as well as Africa. We were in Spain, Portugal, France, Germany, Netherlands. That was us. The castles that you see throughout the online and all, those were our castles. And this is evidence and proof that they came against us and fought against us. They made war against us. Can we get the wording? Can you see that, Yuri?
Yes, sir. I'll read the bottom one, 9 and 10.
Yes.
Wild men and Moors.
The word Moors means black. That's all it means. Hey, Yuri, real quick, let me show. They tell you that in the book of Micah.
Micah chapter 1, verse 1. The word of the Lord that came to Micah, the Moorishite.
See that? Moorishite means black. The root word there, Moor, is black. This is where the terminology Moor comes from. But you never learned that in Sunday school. Let's go on back. That's all I wanted, Yuri. Give me the next picture. It's the Pucci family at the top. That's the Pucci family. Okay. You can see it at the top. It's P-U-C-C-I. And it says, bottom right, it says, if you give me the highlight, Alicia, bottom right, see the year? 1466, y'all see that? And then top left, go to top left. What's that year say? I can't see it too well.
1673.
1674. Right, so the Pucci family, which were black men, you see them right there, were ruling. Okay, then they don't want the CRT, get it out to school. Don't teach them nothing. You might inspire one or two of them. Give me the next image. Okay, as you see again, this is what the popes instituted: war against us. Get us out of Europe, get us out of Spain, get us out of Portugal, get us out of France, get us out of Germany. And the crusaders and the various kings came against us and made war against us. Is there any writing lifted up? Let me see.
Charlemagne's siege of the town of Agen, defended by a black Saracen named Agilon. The emperor carries the shield with the eagle, and his horse's equipment is marked with the fleur-de-lis.
That's the lily. Fleur-de-lis is the lily. Go ahead.
On the enemy side, black soldiers, Bando, and the shield with the lion's head or the six-pointed star.
Notice what it calls us, the enemy. In Esau's history, in Esau's story, we are always the enemy. We are always the villains. That's how they write us in their books.
Like I said in my original video, I've had this argument with people before. I don't know why it's so difficult for people to grasp. Maybe it's because of our Americanized thinking of black and white. Like I said, hold up, I'm going to break it down for you, okay? The original Moors were from Africa. But have you ever heard of the Romans? Of course you have. The Romans started in Rome, Italy. That's why they were named the Romans. Now, when they went out and conquered other lands and became dominant over the indigenous people, the lands they conquered, those people became Romans also. So all the Romans, even though the Romans started in Rome, all the Romans of different lands that were underneath the Roman rule, we're of different ethnicities. It's the same thing with the Moors. The Moors originated in northern Africa, and they went out and conquered other lands. So those people of the other lands ended up being Moors too. Just in case, you know, you wasn't understanding what I was trying to say, you see, Rome stretched all the way from England to Egypt and in between the Mediterranean basin. All those different people had all different skin tones, but they were all Romans. This is what Google says. The Moors initially were indigenous Berbers, okay? The name was later applied to Arabs and you know, Arab countries. Pay attention to that picture at the top that shows a Moor. I'm explaining where the origins of that comes from. And what does this say? They were an ethnic group indigenous to North Africa, okay? But getting back to this painting of a Moor, it was done by a Dutch artist that was born in 1575, died in the 1600s. Dutch. By American standards, that would be considered white, right? Well, you see, he wasn't an American, so he didn't have to whitewash the history. This was a portrait of a Moor that he did. The same man, same artist, Dutch artist, his name was Jan something, did a portrait of this Moor. And when you Google the original Berbers, this is the map that comes up, Northern Africa. Now, reading from your name, I can assume you're Sicilian, and I don't know what you were taught in your family history or your lineage. You know, I don't understand why it's so difficult for people to grasp the concept that there were Africans that conquered lands too. And the reason why this is left out of a lot of American history is because during colonial slavery, and still colonial slavery mentality that this country is built upon, that's still used today, didn't want slaves to know that once they were conquerors and powerful people as well. Just like the Roman Emperor Severus, that was an African.
I forgot that hatred stems from people who hate their own existence. I forgot I'm better off alone. I forgot I care for everyone's happiness but forget about my own. I forgot I spend every